The roundtable, held by civil activists in the IRFS Media Center, focused on appalling conditions and lawlessness in Azerbaijani prisons. The issue has become a subject of lively discussions after a letter was publicized by Azerbaijan National Statehood Party Chairman Nemet Panahli, who is serving sentence in prison number 17. The initiators of the meeting were the Human Rights Club, the Institute for the Protection of Human Rights and Freedoms, the Alliance for the Protection of Political Freedoms, and the Azerbaijan with No Political Prisoners Community Alliance. Lawyer Elchin Namazov expressed his deep concern over an increase in the number of suicides and deaths in jails. An appeal was sent to the prosecutor's office demanding a lawsuit to be filed in connection with the alleged suicide of inmate Parviz Mikayilov on December the 16th in the jail number 17. According to the lawyer, the Gobustan prison stands out from all other prisons in Azerbaijan in terms of its brutal torture and death of prisoners. Prisoners also die in the hospital of the Penitentiary Service, as it happened to the prisoner Murad Shukurov and others. Human rights activist Oktay Gulaliev called for solidarity and resistance against this tyranny. If someone dies in the Penitentiary Service, the responsibility for this lies with the state, said lawyer Anagi Hajibeyli. He believes that the appeals to international organizations and the European Court on these facts should be sent more intensively. Lawyer Sabali Mustafaev reported that he defends the rights of five lifers who need serious treatment but are deprived of it. Lawyer Gurban Mehmedov considers it necessary to provide support and protection to Nemet Panahli and all other prisoners whose rights are regularly violated. The regime understands that it is approaching to the end, therefore they are so rude, said Mehmedov. Torture in prisons is a policy of the state and not of individual officials, said the head of the Popular Front Party, Ali Karimli. We have to prevent these incidents, which have become a regular occurrence, Karimli said. The effort to break people's pride and courage occurs everywhere, in the army, in prisons, and in political arena. The authorities do not want citizens with dignity and pride. Ilham Aliyev is responsible for all this, he said. There is a need for a permanent coalition to deal with all cases of violations of prisoners' rights. It is necessary to develop a list of persons who torture detainees and to submit their list to relevant organizations, proposed Karimli. Mother of Parviz Mikayilov, who died in jail number 17 on December the 16th, also attended the meeting. My son was tortured and killed, and he did not commit suicide, she said. He spent 3 years in jail number 16 on charges of resisting the police. On December the 9th, he called his sister and said that he did not feel well. And when on December the 13th his wife Mirvari met him at the prison hospital, we learned that he had been severely beaten. According to lawyer Irada Javadova, on December the 15th, Mikhailo was taken back from the hospital to the jail number 16. However, the jail did not accept him, stating that when Mikhailo was sent to the hospital, he was in a good condition. Therefore, he was taken to the jail number 17, where he died the next day. At the end of the meeting, the participants signed an appeal to the government requesting to investigate negative events occurring in jails, as well as to provide civil society stakeholders with an opportunity to monitor the places of detention.